Hello everyone, I'm Yuping from PingCAP. Today, Shuning and I are glad to share how we brought elastic and resilient multi-tenancy to TiKV in the last year. We will cover our approach and its benefits. This sharing will consist of four parts. First, I will briefly introduce what TiKV is. Then, I will describe why we need multi-tenancy and what challenges it brings. In the third session, Shuning and I will share our solutions to address these challenges. Finally, we will share some thoughts on the future. Okay, let's start from what is TiKV. TiKV is a graduated project of the CNCF. It is a highly scalable, low latency, and easy to use distributed key value database that provides both raw and ACID transactional key value APIs. It serves as the storage layer of TiDB, a transactional database widely used in online serving services, as well as the metadata storage system for object storage services. TiKV supports ACID transactions, replicates logs using Raft, and uses range partitions to split and merge dynamically. It also supports coprocessor for SQL operator pushdown. If you would like to learn more about TiKV, please visit TiKV.org. Okay, now let's see why we need multi-tenancy. Multi-tenancy is required to address several issues on large TiKV clusters. Firstly, there are a number of different services on the cluster, and multi-tenancy is needed to isolate and guarantee the QoS of different groups of services. Secondly, compared to having multiple TiKV clusters, multi-tenancy can share some infrastructure such as control panels, metrics, and alarms to reduce costs and simplify cluster maintenance. Finally, for some customers, multi-tenancy can meet their requirements to use both transition KV and raw KV in the same cluster. Multi-tenancy presents significant challenges that must be addressed to ensure the elastic and resilient operation of TiKV. Firstly, TiKV must be able to handle data volumes ranging from GBs to PBs. Additionally, TiKV must be able to support millions of tenants in a single cluster, each with its own unique storage and processing requirements. Secondly, multi-tenancy requires to isolate and reduce the blast radius of failures. With multiple servers running on the same cluster, a single failure can potentially affect multiple tenants, resulting in a large blast radius. To mitigate this risk, TiKV must provide strong isolation mechanism that prevent failures in one tenant from affecting others. Additionally, TiKV must be able to recover quickly and without data loss in the event of fatal errors and disasters. Now, let's discuss our solution for achieving elasticity and resilience. Our first solution is to use KeySpace to isolate different tenants. To isolate data between different tenants, we use KeySpace with specific key modes. Regarding the TiKV mode, we use the key prefix M for TiDB metadata. For table rows, we use the key format T table ID, R row ID with the corresponding column values. In the case of index rows, we use the key format T table ID, I index ID, index columns value, and row ID with no corresponding value. Moving on to the TiKV mode, for transaction keys, we utilize the key prefix X for transaction keys. For row KV keys, we use the prefix R. Then to isolate different tenants, we use KeySpace to prefix user keys. Previously, we used the mode prefix followed by the user key and a timestamp. Now, the keys of raw KV, transition KV, and TiDB will be encoded with mode prefix, KeySpace, user key, and timestamp. The KeySpace is a fixed length of 3 bytes in net by order, with a maximum key space ID of 16.7 million. The timestamp of raw KV entries is used to implement the change data capture feature that indicates what and when data is changed. To manage TiSpace. We add TiSpace management capability in PD, which includes allocation of KeySpace ID by KeySpace name, creation of a new KeySpace by KeySpace matter, updating of KeySpace matter and configuration, management of KeySpace life cycle, and retrieval of KeySpace matter. Finally, this diagram provides an overview of the data isolation achieved through KeySpaces. Okay, in the next session, it will introduce microservices related to PD. Okay, Shuning, over to you.
Okay, thanks. And I want to talk about the microservices in Plasma Java. Plasma Java is a critical component of the TiKV. Microservice is an architectural style that structures an application as a couple of loosely coupled services, which are small and independent in nature, and can be deployed independently without affecting the whole system. Now, let's dive into the details of how this architecture is being used in Plasma Java. As we know, TiKV is a distributed key value storage system that is designed to be scaled by adding more TiKV nodes to the cluster. However, the Plasma Java may be a bottleneck in scalability in the very large size cluster, such as we found some user say like the TiKV can be scaled by scaling the TiKV nodes, but the Plasma Java cannot. And the Plasma Java provide many services, and there are too many jobs to handle it. And they are also concerned about the stability and the high availability of the Plasma Java. To address these challenges, we have split the Plasma Java to multi-services in TiDB Cloud, which allowed for better scalability, fault tolerance, and better performance. First, let's to look at the services. There were many services that were provided by the Plasma Java. There is service including the metadata service, the timestamp oracle service, the scheduling service, and the allocation service. All of them were combined into a single component. This made the Plasma Java be a single point of the value in the TiKV system, which was a big concern of the users. Let's look at the table. The TSO service was responsible for generating and assigning the timestamp to the TiKV transaction to ensure the data consistency. It's very critical and require more resources once there are many transactions in the cluster. The metadata service in Plasma Java was responsible for managing the cluster metadata, including the node information, region information, and the other system information. It's also critical. Some services relied on it, and also it's required some resource to handle the request, such as the request for the TiKV heartbeats. And another service is the allocation service. It's a neat same as the timestamp oracle service, but it's not required by user side, it's internal. So the resource requirements are less. And there is a scheduling service that is response for scheduling the TiKV resource, including the balance region distribution and the node balance. But it's not affect the TiKV transaction available. So there are some services were not critical to the TiKV, but they were combined into single point component, which made it difficult to scale the critical functions. The microservice architecture in Plasma Java has allowed it with isolating these critical services into a separate service. Here is an overview of the microservices in Plasma and Java. As the picture shown, the PD has split into multi-service. Each service responds for a specific function. Actually, the service we already introduced in before, it's needed to be noted that there is a storage service in here. The storage service can be etcd classed in here. It's responsible for storing the data of the other service in the PD. And the other service can be looked as a stateless. And by the etcd API, the all other service has the same high availability mechanism. Next, I will mainly introduce the TSO service and the metadata service. The TSO service in TiKV is responsible for allocating monotonically increasing timestamps for all the transactions in the cluster. This ensures that the transactions are executed in the consensus order. The TSO service is an important part of the distributed system like TiKV and ensure that all the nodes in the class have a consistent view of the time. After we split the TSO service as the picture, it's used etcd as the underlying storing engine to store the TSO metadata. To ensure fault tolerance and high availability, the TSO service is required more than two replicas. Where one is designed as a primary and the others as a secondary. The primary TSO node is responsible for providing the actual TSO allocation and the metadata possessed to the etcd, while the secondary TSO nodes will watch the need key of the primary TSO nodes in the etcd and also ready to take over if the primary TSO nodes have a failure. The TSO nodes also use the election algorithm for the etcd to ensure that only one primary TSO nodes to provide the TSO service. The TSO service is critical to the cost and required high performance to ensure the large throughput. Separate it from the Plasma driver make it is not impacted by other services running in the Plasma driver. Moreover, the resource contention is reduced since the TSO service can fully use its own resource and the runtime overhead is reduced, resulting in the performance is improved. In addition to split the TSO service, we also partition it for different tenants as shown in the picture. Each tenant was assigned to a group, and each group has its own TSO service with its own metadata stored in etcd, and to provide the TSO service for each group. This partition allows us to achieve the scalability to reduce the failure risk, which means that if there is a failure with one group TSO service, it won't affect the other tenant group. Another important service is the metadata service. The metadata service in Plasma Driver collect the metadata information for TiKV through the heartbeat message. The information including the data about the TiKV nodes, such as the IP address, available disk space, status, and the region information. The TiKV clients get the metadata from the plasma driver to route the proprietary TiKV nodes for access, and also client will catch the metadata to reduce the access to the plasma driver. The metadata service is also a single point of failure and bottleneck for the TiKV class as it grown in bigger size. By splitting it into microservice, we can increase the upper limit and scale the meta service for each tenant. With this approach, we can evolve it into more scalability service and reduce the impact on the whole class. Same as above about the TSO service, the metadata service in PD relies on etcd for possessing data. TiKV nodes send the heartbeat to update the metadata information. Those metadata information is used by plasma driver to route the client request to the TiKV nodes. And also, we introduce a common neighbor that is meta informer, which can list and watch the region and store metadata updates by the tenant. Each tenant can use the meta informer in the client side to maintain a cache in local. So even if the meta service has a failure, in a short time, the cache can provide the route information to access the data. Moreover, in the failure time, the meta informer can also get the region information from the TiKV nodes directly. So it can update the metadata information for TiKV directly. So the availability of the service, of the metadata service, can be guaranteed. That's all of my part. Yeah, thanks. Yuping, please.
Okay, thanks. Now we come to the last section about future outlook. As we move forward, we aim to provide fine-grained control of resources for tenants, including CPU, memory, disk capacity, and throughput, as we also plan to offer services based on multi-tenancy, which will provide a virtual cluster for every tenant. This will enable users to start or stop a cluster in seconds and to automatically scale in and out. These improvements will enable more efficient and flexible use of TiKV, as well as make it more accessible to a wider range of users. In conclusion, we have discussed the key aspect of TiKV, the significance of multi-tenancy, our solutions to overcome its challenges, and the future possibilities. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.